Hare Krishna. Can we use Tulasi as medicine in life-threatening diseases? Answer: Tulasi is definitely not meant to be used only as a medicine, nor is it meant to be rejected as absolutely banned for medicinal purposes. Now, the focus is we want to see Tulasi transcendentally. And just as we have an offense to against the holy name, that to not give some material interpretation of the holy name. So like that, if some people take Tulasi just for its medicinal value, then they are seeing that which is transcendental materially, and that is not good. So that's what we want to discourage, because when we see something transcendental materially, that is undesirable. But then again, all this depends on time, place, circumstance. Some people may chant the holy names just for the sake of stovanam helanam evava, just for the sake of music, for the sake of teasing others, but it said the holy name will benefit them also. So that means there are different levels. One who doesn't know about the glory of the holy name and doesn't know about how it is such a great thing, then that person, if that person chants the holy name for some other motive also, for musical satisfaction or for just teasing others, even that will lead to benefit. But a sadhaka who has come to know about Krishna, Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, that person chants the holy name negligently, that is undesirable. That is something which should be avoided. So there is the chanting of the holy names among the ignorant, and that is not considered offensive. But those who know and then they act neglectful, they are considered offensive. Same way with Tulasi also. So if it's materialistic people who don't know anything about the glories of Tulasi Devi from the point of view of how she is an expansion of an intimate associate of Radharani, and she is a consort of the Lord, and she is manifested in this extraordinary form because of a special pastime. So they have no appreciation for Tulasi, and if they just see Tulasi medicinally, okay, this is a plant which has medicinal value, then at least somehow or the other they are appreciating Tulasi Devi. And maybe for after seeing, oh, this plant has so much medicinal value, I want to know more about it. And then they may come to associate with devotees who tell her about the not just the cultural but the spiritual value also of medicine from the philosophical point of view and the devotional point of view. And then that may begin their bhakti also. So if somebody cultivates Tulasi for medicinal purposes, it's not wrong. If that person knows nothing about the glories of Tulasi Devi, that's at least some way, some sort of agyan sukruti is happening, because some appreciation for Tulasi is there. Now we may say, okay, that person is plucking Tulasi leaves and is eventually going to see it only from utilitarian perspective. That is fine. There are people who may see prasad also from a utilitarian perspective. Now, are they offensive? They just take prasad and consume it. No, they're not offensive over there. It is, they are somehow or other connecting with Krishna. So now with respect to devotees, if somebody is, say, having a life-threatening disease and which is incurable by any other means, then can a devotee take Tulasi as a medicine? Now, it's not that we are banned from taking Tulasi. As generally, when devotees are sick, they can even take medicines which may contain some meat and meat products. Now, ideally, devotees try to avoid that kind of medicine and take vegetarian medicines which are made of vegetarian components, plant products. But if that sort of medicines are not available, then a medicine which contains some item which is normally forbidden, that is acceptable. Because the point is, ultimately the regulative principles are meant to give up the enjoying mentality. And if there is no enjoying mentality over there, it's primarily being taken as a medicine, then it is not considered wrong. So similarly, just as if one can take even things which are forbidden because they are considered sinful, then what to speak of something which is like Tulasi Devi? So if it's a life-threatening situation, and if normal medicines don't work, and if some doctors recommend Tulasi as a last resort, then taking medicine made of Tulasi is not wrong. And actually, it's something which we, as if devotees are doing it, then we can also try to have not just a medical or utilitarian attitude, but we also try to have a devotional consciousness. So when we take that as a medicine, we focus on meditating how Krishna is, actually this Tulasi Devi is not just a herb. Tulsi Devi is a Vaishnavi, Mahavaishi, great devotee, and we can pray to her for her blessings, so that the blessings that if she so desires, she may cure the person physically. But even if that doesn't happen, at least she can bless so that the person will be elevated spiritually. So if we have the right devotional disposition, then even taking Tulsi is not considered wrong at that time. The important point in the devotee's normal avoidance of Tulsi is to minimize or avoid seeing as material that which is transcendental. But that doesn't mean that the material aspect is to be denied or rejected. So if the material aspect is useful, then at a material level, then we can use it, but without denying or without forgetting the spiritual aspect. In fact, our focus should always be on spiritual as much as possible, and then use the material aspect accordingly, wherever it is absolutely essential. Thank you. Hare Krishna.